the government police department immediately inquire how this bomb came, where from, who placed it. That is humanity. That is human reason. Lawful of a sudden there is. You have to accept that. You accept that? Then? No sane man will accept. The so-called scientists beginning, all beginning is like that. There are chemicals, these chemicals. Where from these chemicals came? Who placed these chemicals? They do not ask, because they are fools. The other fools bluff them and they accept it. But we are not going to accept. We shall inquire.
Yeah.
And that is human intelligence.
But then they say, where did God come from?
Huh?
They say, where did
God not come from? By experience you are speaking, the things are just like the explosion. Explosion was there because God was there. Therefore God is there. The explosion cannot take place by chance all of a sudden. There was somebody, some brain, and that brain is God. Because you say all of a sudden there was explosion, therefore that is the proof of existence of God. Is it clear or not?
Yes.
You say...
Something can't come from nothing.
No, we have no such experience. How we accept this nonsense statement? We have no such experience. I can accept something that is going on. Can you show me? So you study with your experience. Where is your experience that something comes all of a sudden? There is no such thing. How can I accept your statement? Because you say there was explosion, that means there is God. That means that is God. So what is your argument? You say that, why you bring God? I bring God because you say there was explosion.
No, you're saying that something cannot come from nothing.
Yeah.
So, therefore this explosion came from God.
Yeah.
But then where did God come from?
Huh?
Where did God come from?
That is God. God is always existing, not come from. That is God. Nitya, nityana, you are also existing. That this knowledge they are lacking. Just like I am, you are. We are eternal. We are changing body because they do not believe, do not try to understand that I am not this body. Therefore, the whole mistake is there.
The scientist would say, well, since I have not experienced that I'm eternal, therefore how can I accept that I'm eternal?
Yes, you are eternal, because you are a child. And now you are grown up. But you know that you are a child, therefore you are eternal. You are a child, but you have known that child's body. Now you have got a different body. So although you have got a different body, you know that you had a body like a child. Therefore, body has changed. You have not changed. That is eternity.
And nobody wants to die.
Nobody wants to die.
If the soul is not eternal, where has that desire?
This is eternity. This is practical eternity. You have changed so many times your body, but you are the same person. Therefore, you are eternal in spite of changing body. This is simple argument.
I used that argument once to the Prabhupada, and the scientist said to me, it is the chromosomes, these tiny chromosomes that do
that. That is their jugglery of what, this rascal. Chromosome, he'll manufacture some word. But what is your chromosome of child body? What is that child body? Where it has gone? If you know chromosome, where your child's body gone? That That is the difficulty. These rascals, they do not know anything, still they are teachers and manufacturers of jugglery awards, that's all. That is the difficulty. Kramsam. What is that Kramsam? What does it mean, Kramsam?
It's a tiny structure of organic matter that can constantly reproduce.
That's how when reproduce, the last body is gone.
They say that the chromosomes are transferred from father to son.
Still, the father's body is not the son's body. There's different body.
It's come from father's body.
That all right. But the father's body is different. The father's pains and pleasures, the son's pleasure and pleasure are not the same. It may be that the father has given the ingredient of the body, but that does not mean the father's body and the son's body the same. Like the mind is same, like the intelligence is same, it's all different. Otherwise, why a son becomes disobedient to the father? I don't agree with you. That means your intelligence, your mind is different from my mind. I cannot agree with you. Therefore, everything is different.
They can accept that our bodies are changing now, but in the next life, they have no experience of this.
This is experience. You are a child. This is your next life.
They can see this body change, but the next life they cannot see.
That means you have no. You cannot see so many things. That is means that does not exist. What is the value of your eyes? That I already explained. You cannot see. Now it is misty. You cannot see anything. Does it mean your eyes are perfect? How you can see? Your eyes are not perfect. What you cannot see, you have to hear. Suppose in a distant place I cannot see. What is that light, I say? But if somebody knows, oh, that light is from, there is a sky-covered building like this, and the light is coming. So I know. What I cannot see, I can hear. Therefore, what you do not see in next life, you have to hear from authority. That is stated in the Bhagavata. Tatha dehantaram prapti. As you have changed so many times in this life, this body, similarly, after death, he'll change your body. So that is authority. You have to hear. Anything you cannot perceive, you cannot experiment with your senses, you have to hear from another person who knows. That is the process.